Good morning, everybody. It's Friday, and it's Good Friday. So, I wish I had something more kind of profound to show or to work on Good Friday here. Especially with a game named The Resurrection. So, we're going to burn some thatch, but actually we're going to unburn some thatch. So, that's kind of an ashes to risen again sort of theme. So, we'll go with that. I hope you're going to have a great Easter weekend, regardless of where you are and what you're doing. So, I've built a little shader, and I think it's hideously inefficient, and it doesn't quite do exactly what I want it to do necessarily, but it's another triplanar-based shader, but this time, it's mapping across a kind of a dissolve effect. Everybody's seen these dissolve effects. They're absolutely everywhere. I've built one or two of these, but of course it's been a while ago, so I had to remind myself yesterday how to do it. But here it is on the thatch on the church, and you can see it's kind of about halfway done, and we've got edges. We've got the main color of the thatch, and then we've got edges that are like a brighter color. And these are actually emissive, so they should show up pretty nicely during the nighttime of the cycle. And if you just send a slider back and forth, you can burn this off. And burn it back on. So it's not really a very realistic burn. I'd like to... there are no UVs in any of the meshes in this game. So instead, the UV channel is used for lots of other different things, but the mapping here of this normal texture, it's not normal, this noise texture, is just done in triplanar shading, which is, again, kind of creating UV textures based on the world rather than on the mesh, and it works pretty well. We can control the tiling and that sort of thing, so that's pretty cool. But one day I would like to make it so that this kind of effect would kind of fade off based on a Y value as well, so that we'd be running the burn amount, which would be great, but we're also running the burn amount in a Y value, so it would like burn back up. Or in this case, because we're going to run the effect backwards, it's going to burn back up. I'll play with that a little bit. But for right now, we have the basic effect in place. The tiling repeats. I've got a 0.2 tiling, and you can see it repeats 1, 2, 3. I should probably change that. So let's make our tiling 0.1. And we still have one big repeat. I should do something about that, but yeah, I think probably most people aren't going to notice too badly that that's what's going on. So anyway, triplanar shaders are probably not the most efficient in the world, but that's okay. We're just going to play with this for now. Maybe later on I'll think of a better way to do it. So I'm just messing around with the shading now. Like 0.05 tiling, we get no repeats in the mapping of the texture anywhere. And I kind of like that chunkier version of it, so let's work on that. Okay, so the big idea is that we're going to have this material, and it's always going to be at zero. Let's go grab... Okay, so... Let's swap this back, ASC, VC, or vert color only. Okay, so this is only vert coloring. So this is a really simple shader, and it's just grabbing the vert colors and displaying them. Boom, that's it. Great. And it's a surface shader, which means when this project moves over to 2021 or whatever it is, version of Unity, which is kind of out there currently, I'm going to have to rebuild all of these shaders. Because surface shaders were like the next best thing for many years in Unity, and then they just like, no, we can't do surface shaders anymore. You can do surface shaders, but if you want to try to put them into the universal render pipeline, which is kind of notionally the most efficient, you've got to kind of work with the fact that it's all forward rendered and there's no surface shaders anymore. I don't know. Things get complicated. That's a bridge to burn later on. All right, so what we need to do is we need to, of course, write a script. we need to get the thatch, both in the chancel and in the nave, we need to get the thatch to burn back up. So let's go back to our burn shader. Our burn material now, not our shader. We're going to start it at 0, and we're just going to lerp it back up to the top. So that's not a problem, and then we'll swap out materials. So this is kind of a material swap process. So I'm going to need to...
Oh, pardon me.
I'm going to need to, when the build is done of the whole building, that's when I need to unlock this object and it needs to do its burn in. So I think I'm just going to create a script to do that rather than altering the whole object material script. I think we'll put a whole object material on this, will we? Probably so. I don't know what's controlling. I'm trying to figure out what's actually controlling how these things appear in time. Whole object material has a start. They're off on start, which means that once they turn on and we jump time periods, they're going to stay on, I bet. Let's actually give that a shot. Let's turn off our thatch for now. I'm just thinking that we may need to put something else that's going to control their time periods on here. It's like this has a soil info script on it, which is calling listen for first frame. Which is controlling when these things appear. Yeah. I wonder what's going to start and stop. What's going to prevent these things from turning on and then staying on when we jump times? Probably won't worry about that for now. We'll probably just take one thing at a time. I can put a general object info or something on them. But let's see what happens here as it goes along. Okay, there we go. Let's cheat. Don't worry about the rubble on the west end. Let's rebuild this one. Look, I fixed the roof trusses. Isn't that nice? Okay, so these guys are now on. If I jump again, no, why did that happen? What stopped these guys? Time A, time B. Okay, well, these are in time B. Let's jump, let's cheat again, and let's jump to the mesolithic and see what happens. Yeah, there they are. They're going to appear again. Yeah, they need something controlling their timing. I was just wondering if some other object somewhere deep within the game was controlling their timing visibility, and that's not true. And that's fine. What if this holes holder just gets a general object? General object info. It's occupy, it's got a start date and end date, it's going to set its child layers. I don't want to necessarily turn on the thatch. I don't want to necessarily turn on anything. So let's see what happens with this one. Start date is going to be 800, end date is going to be 950. User build date's gonna be 850. Okay. Let's find out what happens when this when we turn this thing on here. I really probably shouldn't get sidetracked by this. I want to get sidetracked by getting the burn effect to happen. Let's let it go through here. Dawn here is really kind of crazy beautiful in that we have a very light pink sky fading into a really bright yellow one. The light pink's bouncing off the clouds, which we usually don't have in the morning, and the sun's kind of coming in under the cloud layer. It's quite nice. Okay, all these guys are off, so that's great because they're supposed to be off. Let's cheat, jump into this time period. Great, let's rebuild this one. That's weird. Okay. And that should turn itself off. It finally has. Okay. Cool. Let's jump back to this period. And then let's jump to this period. Ooh, look at that. Well, that's interesting. Okay, that's wrong. That shouldn't be happening. These guys should have... Oh, well. We'll focus on that time period stuff here in a minute. Instead, let's just get this to work on doing its own... I'm going to turn off that manager. Let's just get this to focus on burning this in first. Okay. Time to make a new script. Give both of these. Oh yeah, that needs to be on. That was what I wanted. Let's give both of these the same whole object behavior component. It's thatch as its renderer, and this is going to get its thatch as its own renderer. Okay. Great. And I was just looking at this material fade on placement. That's for the different fader. Oh, so many things to fade. Let's pre-populate this script. And let's pre-populate this one to just figure out any hidden variables we might have. Okay. So this is going to call lock, unlock. I don't think the whole object behavior script actually has a lock and unlock in it, which is good because we don't want that to mess with it. And we're just going to create a script just to control burning here. I'm just going to dig around in the script for a minute. Just going to dig around in here. Oh, Microsoft. Always getting in the way, Microsoft. Material lerp. Yeah, triprint planar. So it's grabbing a material off of one central place. Okay. Let's see, how is it doing this material lerp here? Let's see. It's setting it individually. So it's actually just growing. Sorry, what I'm looking at here is that it's actually just messing with its own shader, its own shader instance before jumping into the completed version here. Sorry, my head's all over the place this morning. So maybe we are just kind of duplicating these materials and then dumping everything in into one kind of shared material. Well, maybe that's what we do. Material fade in, fade out, fade in. Triplanar to zero mat. Triplanar lerp one mat. What scripts run this one? What scripts reference this one? Whole object behavior, just right there. So it has a shared material on placement. Oh, that's just for resetting. Right, okay. Fair enough. We're going to do this a little bit differently, but I'm going to add another material in, because why not? Public material, burn in mat. Okay, so that's stuck in there. The whole object is just going to turn itself on. That's great. We don't really need the whole object behavior for anything else, and whole object behavior does not listen for a lock or unlock call, I hope. First frame, set orientation, check orientation, fade in, report load clone, state changed. Great, it doesn't really call that. So that's good. Let's just create a new little script here. Why not? I've already got a million scripts. We're just roughing this out, just prototyping this. Burn in we're gonna call it burn in mat behavior. We're gonna add it to both of these. There we go, thank you. Burn in material behavior. Okay, I'm already anticipating a problem that's going to happen, but let's have that problem later. Let's grab these. Put these away. Let's set up some things here. What are we going to set up here? What variables do we have? Well, we can call this one burn in time, and let's have that burn in time equal 1 second. What else are we going to need to maybe be able to control burn in time? No, because I'm just going to run these both at the same time. Okay. All right, let's set up some functions here. Call this burn in. And call this burn in update. This is going to be the thing that actually does the job. And then public void burn in on complete. So this is what's going to happen after it's done burning in. All right, burn in. Burn in's going to call lean tween value, and we're going to run from 0 to 1. And we're going to call burn in update. And the time's going to be burn in time, so over burn in time. Burn in update's got to take a value. We'll just call it that. I can't quite remember the syntax on this. So let's go grab our whole object behavior, because that tells us how to do that. I can never remember how to set this thing up where I want to, on a big tween, I want to pass something. So it's game object and then the, okay. Right, let's do this one. Game object and then burn in update. Then we set our from and to, and then we set the burn time. Great, and then we do set on complete, and the complete thing we're gonna call is burn in on complete. Marvelous. Oh, there's one more thing it needs to have. It needs to have a, I'm even gonna just make this public. Mesh render, call that my MR. All right. So the burn in update's going to take, Well, we'll see what happens. Let me just think about this. How many times are we going to burn these guys in? I'm going to do another one. Oh. Maybe I shouldn't have saved this stuff for the end of the week when I'm worn out. Burn in start. Okay, mymr dot shared material equals, is that what we're looking for? How do I set that? Yeah. Equals grand central dot instance dot burn in mat right there. That's the one. Okay, so that one's set. Ooh, we need another one, another public one, which is public material end material, end mat we'll call it. Okay, so that's set, that one. And then it just runs over and it calls in burn in. Burn in runs. As burn in runs, it sets grand central dot instance dot burn in mat dot set float. The name of that float is burn amount, I think. Let's go take a look at that again. Burn amount, yep. So the property on the material is called burn amount, and it needs to be set to the value that's being passed to it every frame. Great. And then when it's complete, it says my mesh renderer dot shared material equals end mat. Okay, hopefully this is going to help us to avoid lots of extra draw calls, but it doesn't really matter at this point. So that whole thing, that really simple script should do it. We just have to remember to set the material here and then to set up all of these variables. Let's let it compile. Oh gosh, no. Got one more thing to put in here. Void on enable. Messenger.addListener. This is the thing we wanted to do. And it's listening for a lock event. I just can't remember what lock. I think the lock event's looking for a game object name. Yeah, it's looking for a string. Okay. So, string, not lock, it's just looking for an unlock. And that's going to call burn in start. What am I doing wrong? Add listener string, quote unquote unlock, and then the name of the thing it wants to call. What am I doing wrong? Ooh, maybe I should have taken a break today. I'm so wiped out. This week has been a kind of a rough week. Had to move a neighbor out of his house. He's being evicted. Which is sad. And it's been really stressful. So I'm just not being able to see, like, really normal, obvious things here. I don't understand. Oh, I know, because this isn't taking a string yet. Duh. String sent name. There we go. Now it's fine. If sent name equals game object dot name, which I know is like ridiculously inefficient to call, creates garbage. Oh well. All right. Let's do the remove listener. Then we can set this up. There we go. Okay. Thank you. Can I have my cursor back? That would be great. Apparently I can't. Okay. Great. That's what we want. We want this to listen for a lock or an unlock event. Well, an unlock event. Because we're going to put these two things in the unlocker that when the stage is complete, it unlocks these objects. Good. Okay. No compile errors. Marvelous. Thatch and thatch, they're set to be off on start. They've got the burn-in material. That's great. Let's go set the burn-in material on the controller in the Grand Central script. So here it is, burn material to burn-in material. There we go. That's all we needed in that one, I think. The thatch objects are both going to get their end material is going to be Well, let's not do that. AC vert color only. Very good. And then I just need to set up their individual mesh renderers. There's one. Here comes the other. Okay. That should do it. Oh no, now we've got to go into the stage manager here for this stage, and we need to say the complete unlocks. So when it is completed, it's going to unlock two objects. It's going to unlock the nave thatch. Two objects. Actually, maybe just one. Let's see what happens here. One object and the next object. Oh crud, what'd I just do? Dagnabbit. All right. Let's see what happens. I'm not even sure this is going to trigger an end of a stage completion event, but we'll find out. We'll see. Let's play through it now. Keep on going. There we go. All right, let's jump back in time. And let's rebuild. Okay, the altar's been rebuilt. I still don't know what's going on there with the altar. Our score is 2. That's really good. Let's keep going and see what happens. There's one. Here comes the next one. Here's the last one. Stage is complete. Oh. Well, maybe it helps if I turn these objects on. They are on. No, but they're okay. They're off on start. Right. So it's not getting triggered because it's not on. That makes sense. Okay, look, this is what we're gonna do. I'm gonna uncheck the off on start on these. I'm gonna make both of these. Oops. I'm gonna set their materials as the burn material, and the burn material is set to 0 in its burn, so it's invisible, and these things are going to stay on, I think. And let's find out. they did stay. Okay, good. So they're on. Things look a little bit weird. All right. That was weird. Go in there, turn that one on. Do another little rebuild. Do another little, ooh. Ooh, that was quick. But it burned back in, didn't it? And then it changed its material to the root color. All of that was quite exciting. Well, that was neat. Very cool. All right. Well, that was a fun thing to do. It kind of worked. Hooray for us. There's a whole bunch of cleanup which needs to be done. And I'm setting our burn time to be a little bit longer. So we can do this one again. We need to figure out how to get it. Once these objects are in place, we need to figure out how to make them behave in terms of time. Oh yeah, the object isn't reset. The material isn't reset. I need to add that in. Burn mat. Burn amount needs to go back down to zero. And let's set that up in the script. Their materials end up getting shared, and then the grand central dot instance dot burn mat dot set float underscore burn amount get set to 0.0f. Ta-da. There we go. So that gets reset once the objects get swapped out, once the materials get swapped out. I knew I needed to do that. I'd just forgotten. Let's try again. Give it its time to start up here. Set all the variables it needs to set. There we go. Jump back to that time. Clean that one up. That one's fun. Clean that one up. And I really don't understand why that one stays around. Gotta think about that one for a while. And here we go. Well, cool. That worked great. And then I can also see that the material was set back down to zero, the master material. That worked really nicely. I need to have the dither shader put on this thing. I think I need to kind of build this up and then dither in slowly or something like that. In case the camera's too close. Or I just need to build the dither shader into the burn. I might build the dither shader into the burn, the unburned material. That might be a good idea. But anyway, there we go. Okay, so there we go. Happy Easter, everyone. We have set... Ah. Happy Easter, everybody. We have resurrected a church here today. So... that was kind of fun to see. Glad we were able to do that. And very good. So on Monday, I'm not 100% certain what we'll be jumping into, but we probably need to jump into making sure these objects don't appear in different times, that they pay attention to when they're supposed to be. So I need to kind of work on that over the weekend, and then on Monday we'll be back in and we'll be jumping around in time again. So I hope you have a really happy Easter, everybody. And may you find a little bit of renewed life and a little bit of resurrection someplace in your life, and a little bit of joy and maybe some chocolate. Right? Happy Easter, everyone.